Hey guys, thanks for joining me today. So today I actually have an empties video to share with you guys. So I have a ton of empties that I've been collecting here for the past, I don't know, probably a month or so, but it's finally full. So I don't really do it at a certain time. I just do it when my bin gets full. And just so you guys know, there's not like a ton of Bath & Body Works stuff in here or anything like that, because I do have a really hard time going through my products like that. So this is hygiene, some home, some beauty stuff. It's kind of a mix of stuff. So if that sounds interesting to you, I would love if you stick around and watch this. Also, if you do like content like this, I would love for you to take a moment and hit that subscribe button. And we're just going to go ahead and dig right into this. All right, guys, so let's start. So I have a ton of stuff over here and I'm just going to pull out things randomly. So first, this is the toothpaste that I pretty much use all the time. And I will tell you guys if I'm going to repurchase or anything like that as well in this video. So this is the Hello toothpaste and I actually got this from Target. This is the anti-plaque and whitening fluoride-free toothpaste. I've been using this for probably a couple of years now, and this has been my go-to toothpaste because I do experience a lot of sensitivity in my gums and my teeth. I used to have braces, and I think that caused some issues for me. I have some like recessive gums from it. And this right here does not bother my mouth at all. I've used numerous toothpastes that actually have increased the sensitivity in my mouth, including products that say that they are sensitive. So I don't know what that's about, but this definitely works for me. This doesn't give me any kind of sensitivity or anything like that. I know this is fluoride free. I do use a mouthwash with fluoride for that reason as well. But yes, I will be repurchasing this because I've repurchased this many times before and I will be repurchasing it again. I actually just repurchased it and it's on the way right now. So next up is the mouthwash that I always tend to use. So this is the multi-action mouthwash. This is anti-cavity fluoride rinse fresh mint. And this is just in the Up and Up brand. And this Up and Up brand is actually from Target. It's like their personal brand, like their generic brand, I guess you would say. So this is really cheap compared to the regular Listerine. I used to use the purple Listerine. It was like the total complete mouthwash, but I actually started using this and this is just as good or better. So I've been using this and this is a lot cheaper. So this is only like $3.99 for this huge thing when Listerine, theirs is almost like $10 for the same size. So since it's pretty much like more than half the price, I've just been picking up this one and I've been satisfied with this one. This one works just as good or better, like I said. Do I plan to repurchase this? Yes, and I have already. I have another one that I'm using right now. Next up, I have some sleep earplugs. So this is kind of a weird item, I guess, but I do use earplugs at night sometimes. My husband does have a tendency to snore, so I try to use these when he does, and it has been helping for sure. I've been getting better sleep using these earplugs. I only put them in pretty much halfway through the night. It seems like that's when he does start snoring and I'm not as deep of a sleep. So these have been working out for me really great. I have repurchased these and I will continue to do so. This is a Target brand as well. This is the same Up and Up brand. Their generic stuff is actually pretty good from Target. So I go with this brand quite often. These work really good for sleeping. They're pretty comfortable. Some earplugs are not comfortable for sleeping, but these ones actually are. And they're pretty affordable too. I think they're like $3 or something. Next up, I have a face wash and I use this face wash pretty much all the time. Well, this one or the name brand one, because this is just a generic form of a name brand one. And I go back and forth between this one and the name brand one. So this is just the Daily Facial Cleanser. And this is actually by Equate. And if you don't know, that is a generic brand for Walmart. So this is really reasonable. I think it's like $4. The Cetaphil one that I go back and forth with, That one works just as good. This one works just as good or better too, though. So that's why I go back and forth. And this one's way cheaper. This one's like $4, like I said. And that one, I don't know how much that one is. It's probably like $6 or $7. But it's the same amount of product. It works pretty much the same for me, in my opinion. This one I get right here is for normal to oily skin. And it does say that you can compare it to the Cetaphil Daily Facial Cleanser ingredients. It's the same thing. So I like the generic one just as good. So I've just been saving some money and getting this one. The scent in it is really light too. It's great for my sensitive skin. I am somewhat prone to breakouts, so that actually works really well for me. Next up, I actually have a candle that I finished off. This candle is the brand Better Homes and Gardens. It looks like it got some stuff on it, probably from my other stuff in here. I enjoyed this candle, but it wasn't my favorite. So this is from Better Homes and Gardens, and the scent is farm apple and pumpkin. The notes on here are apple, pumpkin, cinnamon, orange, and maple butter scent notes. So I pretty much just got like an apple pumpkin scent. This one didn't have the best throw. Personally, I think that the Mainstays brand of candles actually works better than this. So if you're not familiar with that, it's a very affordable brand. It's called Mainstays, and it's like the Walmart generic brand for their candles. It works really good, and they actually have some really great scents. I have one right now that I'm using that's a gingerbread scent, and it smells so good. I also love their cozy cashmere scent. So good. But yeah, this one, I probably wouldn't repurchase this, guys. This, I do like the lid. I like the fact that they have this big wooden lid. This is a really nice lid. Like the Mainstays candles, it doesn't have as good of lids. But this one, I pretty much burned it down to nothing. And yeah, this scent, it really didn't throw out that much, but I mean, it's okay. It's kind of like a spicy apple pumpkin scent, in my opinion. So I burned through it, but I would not get this again. I think I just got this from Walmart. But yeah, I probably wouldn't purchase this again. Next, I have these little floss picks. I cannot go without some floss picks in my life. And I've been getting this Up and Up brand. And this is again from Target. Their Up and Up brand is really good. They have a ton of products that you can find in the Up and Up brand. And they work just as good or better than some of these products out here. So these are just the floss picks, and I love these. I have to have these around because I love using them as like the flossers. And then I also use the back end as a pick part to kind of clean out my teeth even more. So I love having these flossers around, and I also have them around because I think they're easier for kids to use as well. So my kids use these too. Next up, I have this hydrocortisone cream. This is just the empty package. I use this when I get any kind of rashes, any little bumps on my skin, and it usually just clears it right up. I also use this around my eyes, and I know you guys probably think that's really weird, but it works really well for around my eyes. I have no idea why it works so good, but I've been using this as like an eye cream for years now. Years. I don't use an eye cream. I just use this and it works really good. I don't know if anyone else does that. I just started doing it one day and it worked so well. I just kept doing it. So let me know if you guys have ever experimented with hydrocortisone cream and using it in different areas. Next up, I have a conditioner here. So this is a hair conditioner and this is the Pantene Pro-V Smooth and Sleek. This says it has 72-hour frizz control. It's just a conditioner. I actually got the set of this one, so I might have a shampoo bottle in here as well in this same kind of smooth and sleek formula. I started using this because I felt like my hair was not the healthiest. I kept using the Aussie shampoo and conditioner, and I felt like they were starting to damage it. They worked really well for like a year or two, and then they started kind of damaging my hair. Like my hair wasn't looking as good. So I went ahead and tried some other products. I've been kind of experimenting more with my hair lately. So I did like this. Would I repurchase this? Yes. And have I? Yes. I've repurchased the same one over again. And it works pretty good. It makes my hair pretty smooth and sleek, like it says. So I like it. So since we're on that, I just seen this on the top, so I'm gonna pull this out too. This is the shampoo, and this is just the Pantene Pro-V Smooth and Sleek shampoo to go with that conditioner. So I use it as a set. I went through a full set of this so far, and I did like it. I have repurchased it. So I am liking this shampoo and conditioner from Pantene. It's been working pretty good. Next up, I have this Juicy Peach soft soap. This is just a basic soft soap. This is only like a buck or something in the stores. I like the soft soaps, and actually they do come out with some limited edition soft soaps around the holidays as well. Usually they have like a peppermint one that I might pick up. I think actually this year they do have a warm cookie one as well in the soft soap brand, which usually the special edition ones are a little bit bigger, so they do cost a little more. They're like $2, $3, but it's definitely worth it. And I think these soaps work just as good or better than like Bath & Body Works hand soap. So I go back and forth between them. Then I do have this. This is the Dove Frosted Plumberry Soap, which I'm using right now. So I've been using this for probably a few days now, almost a week maybe. And I love this. I knew I would love the formula because I've actually used the Berry Brulee plant-based formula before. And I love that one. I've repurchased the Berry Brulee one a bunch of times. And I think that's one that they keep around pretty much year-round. That one smells really good. It smells like berries. This one right here, this Frosted Plumberry one, does kind of remind me of that berry one. The scent, since it does have a berry in this one too, I think, it does remind me of the Berry Brulee one, but it is different as well. So you get a little bit of that berry in here. You also do get kind of a creaminess in here. So I almost get like a yogurt type of feeling from this. I don't know why. It's like the type of scent that's coming off of it. It's almost like giving a creamy yogurt type of feel and smell. And I like it. I don't know if everyone would like it, but I do like it. I like the creaminess with the like berries. It makes it feel really kind of cozy and soft, but it also is very candy-like with the berry, and also the plum kind of gives it this like candiness to it. So it's almost like a creamy candy scent, and I'm all for it. I love this Frosted Plumberry. This is really good, and I've really been enjoying this one. The notes on this one just say frosted plum and sponge sugar. So yeah, it's a really like candy-like plum scent, and it does have kind of a creaminess to it as well. Really like that one. Would I repurchase? I might repurchase if I go through all my other limited edition stuff and, you know, I have time to do so before it's gone for the season. So we'll see about this one. I'm not sure if I'll end up repurchasing this one or not. Next up, I have some more earplugs. These are just the Quiet Time earplugs. I think I got these from Walmart. This is, let's see, Flint's Protex Quiet Time foam earplugs. So yeah, I think I got these from Walmart, and again, it's just the same reason. I use them for sleeping sometimes when my husband is snoring to kind of block out everything. Next up is this Daily Fiber Gummies. I always use a fiber gummy every day. I take like one every evening before bed, and it works. Like, it definitely puts you on if you are off track, if your stomach's off track and your bowels and everything. You might want to try incorporating some fiber into your diet, either by a supplement or, you know, by eating it, because it's definitely helped me. Since I've used this, I became a lot more regular and consistent, and I don't have as many stomach issues. So I definitely recommend taking a fiber supplement. Then I have this Dove Shea Butter and Vanilla Bar Soap. So I went through a few of these actually. I got like a big pack of these, so I might have more of these in here. I don't know. I don't remember, but I do like this. It smells really good. It's not like a pure vanilla. You definitely get that shea in there as well, but it's a nice vanilla shea scent. I think it's really cozy and it's not like a really fresh scent. It's more of like a warm and cozy scent. So if you like to be really fresh in the shower, you might want to try something different, but this is very cozy and comforting and kind of warm in the shower. So I really like this for the fall and winter time. Definitely will be going back to this once all these other limited edition soaps are out, and I use them all up. Then I probably will return back to something more like this. So I did try another Dove soap as well. This is the Soothing Relief, and this says it has 5% nourishing serum with colloidal oatmeal. So this was a really basic soap and it was pretty much unfragranced. Like I really didn't get a fragrance from this or anything, but it worked really well on my skin. I didn't have like any breakouts or anything like that. It was pretty gentle. It's very, very low scent. Like I didn't get really any scent from this. Yeah, I still don't. Maybe like a slight, just like a soap scent, but very, very mild. It's really not fragranced at all. Would I repurchase this one? I don't know if I would repurchase this because this one was a little bit more money than just the regular Dove. And in my opinion, the regular Dove worked just as good. So I probably would not repurchase this one. So I have this little empty package of lashes. This is the lash that I use all the time. These ones are comfortable. They don't hurt my eyes. I've had some eyelashes that do hurt your eyes and they go like kind of dig in the corners of your eyeballs. And I'm not having that. So I would rather not wear lashes at all than experience like pain while I'm wearing them. But these right here, they have been really great. Like since I found these, this is all I want to wear. So this is the Kiss Triple Push Up Collection Lash Couture. And the one that I always get is in Teddy. So it says it right there. It's Teddy and they're the Lash Couture Triple Push Up Lashes. You can buy these on their website or find them in the stores. I kind of go back and forth and do both. I actually have been shopping on the Kiss website because they've been actually having some really great deals, and I have been getting nails as well, as you guys can probably see. So these are just Kiss nails too. These are not like professional or anything like that. I've just been experimenting with the Kiss nails and just using like a nail glue to put them on. They work really well. These stay on for over a week, so to me, they're definitely worth it. And as far as these lashes, I will definitely be repurchasing these. I've already repurchased these numerous times. These are definitely by far my favorite lashes. Next is this lotion right here. If you've watched my empties videos before, you know I usually have one or two bottles of this lotion because this is my nighttime lotion. I always use this lotion at nighttime. And this is just the Jergens Oil Infused Enriching Shea Butter Lotion. I really like this lotion. I've been using this probably for a few years now, and I just use it at night, every single night before I go to bed. I like to have a low scented lotion at night because my husband can be very sensitive to certain smells. So I don't want to like irritate him and give him a headache. He's prone to headaches from scent or certain scents. So I don't like to wear anything super strong to bed. So I just wear this and it's a very low fragrance. There is a little bit of a fragrance in here. It's like a slight shea fragrance, but it's so low of a fragrance. It's not bothersome at all. Next up, I guess I went through a lot of these sleeping earplugs. Like, I don't know how I went through so many sleeping earplugs in this container because usually I only have like one, so I don't know. I must have been dealing with a lot of snoring, I guess, lately. Then I have this right here. So this actually is a Bath and Body Works product, and this is their Glowing Fruit Enzyme Body Polish. I picked this up this last summer and it smells really good. It's kind of like a lime scent, but it's almost like a little bit of a masculine lime scent. I'm not really sure why that is. It's almost giving like a little lime and salt too. So at first it was kind of reminding me of a margarita, but it does kind of have this like manliness to it as well. The fragrance on the back just says it's zesty, bright, salty citrus. So that's pretty much what it smelled like, I guess. But I went through this pretty much through the summer, and then I just finished it off recently because I wanted to get it out of my collection. I've been picking up a ton of scrubs, if you guys haven't noticed, and a lot of holiday scrubs. So I'm trying to get out scrubs from my collection that only have like one or two uses left because I don't need to keep those around. Would I repurchase this? I probably wouldn't repurchase this because I do enjoy other scrubs more than this. I enjoy Tree Hut scrubs and Dove scrubs, and those a lot of times have a better scent and a better grit. Although the grit in this was not too bad. This was actually probably one of my favorite scrubs from Bath and Body Works because they have different types of scrubs at Bath and Body Works. So they have like a creamier scrub, then they have like a sand type scrub. They have different types of scrub, and I did like this one because it was more gritty than a lot of scrubs and it didn't foam up. I don't like the foaming scrubs either, so this one was pretty good for a Bath and Body Works scrub, but I probably would not repurchase this unless it was just a amazing deal. Next up, I have this little circle drink. So I actually, during my last empties, which was a while ago now, I was using this circle bottle, and it's basically you put a cartridge in that's flavored for your water and it makes it that flavor. So I was using these quite a bit for a while, but now I've kind of tapered off. I don't know what it is. I went back to drinking pretty much normal water instead of like flavoring my water, but I was really liking this. Actually, I do need to clean out my circle bottle and start using it again because I do have some cartridges left. So I do need to get around and get that cleaned out and start using it. But this is the strawberry flavor in that circle drink. It's like a cartridge, you put it in there. Strawberry, this one was my favorite flavor. So I still have some strawberry ones tucked away. So when I do clean out that bottle, I'm going to start using it again, hopefully somewhat soon. Because yeah, I've just been drinking regular water. I mean, it's been working, so whatever. So I do have another one in here as well, another strawberry one. Like I said, I was drinking it like crazy for a while and then I kind of just stopped. I think something spilled in here though, because something's really wet. Okay, so this got kind of wet, guys. I don't know what turned and spilled in here, but this is the other candle actually I was talking about that's one of my favorites. This is a Mainstays candle. So this is one from Walmart. It's like their generic brand that we were talking about earlier. This is the scent Cozy Comfort. This is one of my favorite scents from the Mainstays brand right now. And the notes on it are vanilla, jasmine, and musk. To me, it's just really cozy. It's kind of got this light floral, but it's a very cozy, kind of like cashmere type scent. So I've been really loving this one. I burned it down. I actually did repurchase this. I have another one actually sitting in my windowsill right now. So I did repurchase this. Mainstays candles are really good. I'm loving the gingerbread one that I also picked up. That one's really good too. All right, so I did finish off this cinnamon dolce scrub. This was a limited edition item from last year. I absolutely love this scent. It smells so good. I have to say, this is my favorite, probably one of my favorite ever Tree Hut scrub scents, like ever. And I absolutely love it. It's so good, but I did finish it off and I'm so happy because after I finish it off, I was a little bummed because this is like my favorite. I heard that they were getting it back. It was a Target exclusive this year. So I picked another one up. I have it somewhere back here. I got to get another cinnamon dolce scrub right when I ran out of this one. So I'm super happy because that's one of my favorite scents. And I thought it was going to be gone forever, but I was happily surprised that they brought it back as a Target exclusive since so many people liked this one so much and wanted it back that they just decided to bring it back. So I'm super happy about that. I don't want to open this or anything because it's already greasy on the outside. This might be the culprit of whatever's leaking. It smells so good. This is like an edible scent. It smells like almost like a cinnamon churro in a way. It's very cinnamony and it's very buttery. It's such a great fragrance for fall and winter. I absolutely love this one. I had to repurchase this one right away. This is such a great scent. Next up, I have this women's multivitamin. So I always use a women's multivitamin every single day. I've been using this one. So this is the Nature's Bounty Women's Multivitamin Gummies. It's a mixed berry and raspberry flavored gummies. There's 80 of them in here. This actually has collagen in it, and that's why I went with this multivitamin because collagen is supposed to be really good for you, especially as you age and your joints age and everything like that. So I definitely wanted to get a woman's vitamin with collagen in it. So this is what I have been using. But they did run out 1 month. I don't know why, because it's back now. So I was forced to get another one, a different kind of women's vitamin. And I finished this one off too, but I'm actually back to the other one. I've repurchased the one that I just showed you. So this was kind of my temporary fix. Well, that one was not available. So this is the Nature's Truth Women's Multivitamin Gummies, and this also has collagen. This is a mixed berry flavor as well, but there's less of them in here. And I think this one was a little bit more expensive as well. This one was okay, but I prefer the other one. The cost is better on the other one. The taste of the vitamins is better on the other one, and it just feels like it works better. So I went back to using the first one that I showed you, but this was like my temporary fix. Next up, I have another scrub. So this is a cocoa coffee scrub, and this is actually from Pink, Victoria's Secret Pink. This smelled so good. I love the coffee scent on this, but it was time to finish this off and get some more scrubs out of my collection because I'm welcoming in more scrubs. So I had to use up some scrubs. This one's really good though. It just says cocoa coffee. It has coconut oil, Kona coffee extract, invigorating body scrub. So as far as the grit goes, it worked pretty well. It was kind of a medium to low grit type of scrub. It was a little bit fluffy too. So this one smelled really good. It did have kind of like a coconut coffee type scent. Smelled delicious. They actually do their scrubs in different containers now. This is like one of the older containers that they used to use for the Pink scrubs. Now they actually have more of a jar, like a flatter jar and wider instead of smaller and like more height to it. But this worked really well. It was just time to finish this off and get it out of my collection. Would I repurchase this? I probably would repurchase this actually, but they don't have it, so I can't repurchase this. The smell was really good. The grit was pretty good as well. So if it ever comes back sometime, I might possibly purchase this. Here's another lash, and this is the same one. This is in Teddy. We already talked about those, so we're just going to not talk about it again. Then I have this soft soap in Fresh Breeze scent. This is one of the cheap soft soaps again. They work really good for your hands. They don't dry them out or anything. They're very affordable. I have another strawberry cartridge for my drink thing. I have this little packaging from a lip therapy Vaseline product in the flavor Sugar Cookie. So this one, I actually just used it for the first time today, and I think it works pretty good so far, but I don't really have a whole lot of information about that because I really literally just put it on this morning. This was a new product, so I didn't actually go through this whole product. I just opened it and put it in there. It's really cute. It's like a tiny little Vaseline container, and the Sugar Cookie scent is good, or flavor, whatever. It doesn't taste like a full-on sugar cookie, but it's a nice kind of sweet scent. I probably would purchase this again if it works well this time, which it seems like it's working pretty well. It was a pretty thick formula, and that's kind of what I need. My lips tend to dry out and break open when it gets to this kind of weather. So I always have to be protecting my lips with a Blistex, a Vaseline, something to protect them before I put like any color on them or anything like that, because they get very dry and sensitive otherwise. I have this little Cetaphil moisturizing lotion. So I just use this on my face, and I use this every day after I cleanse my face in the shower. I will put this on usually as the moisturizer after I get out. Works really good. It's unscented. It's for dry to normal to sensitive skin. So I do have a little bit of sensitivity. So I try to keep my skincare unfragranced and not too complex, just because I don't want to get a rash or break out or whatever. So I would definitely repurchase that. I have the here's another drink cartridge, same flavor, the strawberry, and another one. So you guys can see I went through quite a few of those before discontinuing that, but I need to pick that habit back up actually. Okay, so I have a little Maybelline eyeshadow here, and this is in the color Vanilla. This is just an eyeshadow single in Vanilla. I use this every single day all over my eyelid, kind of as a primer almost in a way, but it gives more like a pop to your eye when you use a white eyeshadow, which this is. This was in Vanilla and it's a white. So I put it like in the corners of my eyes before I put my eyeliner on and things like that. It kind of just makes your eyes pop. You can put a little bit of whiteness like above your eyebrow, or I mean, right under your eyebrow to kind of like make those pop. It's kind of just like a highlighting type of deal, but I do use it over my eyelid before I put like other eyeshadow on, anything like that. It works really well. Then I have another toothpaste in here, the Hello, the same one we talked about. Then I have a hand sanitizer in here, and this is the Purell hand sanitizer. I always have these by my sinks just in case you need them. Of course, washing is so much better than using sanitizer, but I mean, if you really need to use it, then you know it's there. Okay, so then I have this Great Lash Maybelline mascara, and I get the waterproof kind in very black. So I just use this on days that I don't use fake eyelashes, and also I use it under my eyelashes so they blend in better with the fake eyelashes. So I've been liking this. I've been using this for quite a while now. Then I have this little hand soap, and this is just in the scent Classic Clean, and this is an up and up product, so it's a generic product from Target. These are like a buck, so super affordable. Works just as good as the soft soap one too. Then the foundation that I always use, this is the foundation that I always come back to. I'm sorry that it's disgusting, but I actually use these products and then I didn't go back and wipe them down. So I'm sorry that some of these are kind of disgusting, but this is the Maybelline Fit Me Matte and Poreless Foundation, and I get mine in the color 112 Natural Ivory. This is a go-to for me. I will repurchase this forever until I find a better foundation, I guess. But this one works so good on my skin. I just keep purchasing this one over and over. I trust it. It works well, has good coverage. I don't get all oily from it because it does have a matte and poreless finish. They do have Fit Me foundation in a dewy finish as well. So make sure you get the right formula for your skin if you do get this Fit Me foundation. Like I said, there's like a matte version and then there's a dewy version. So definitely will be repurchasing that. Then I have another one of these shea and vanilla soaps. We already talked about that. Only a couple more things left. Then I have this concealer. This is the Maybelline Cover Stick, and it's like a stick concealer. So it's just like you twirl it up and it's a stick. I don't like the liquid concealers. Like they don't work for me because a lot of what I want to conceal is under my eye. Sometimes I get dark circles under my eyes. So I like to put this on under my eyes, and I've tried liquid concealers before, and they actually rash me out under my eyes. So I just stick to the stick concealer. This is just the Maybelline one. It's in the color Ivory. Then I have this lash glue. This is just the Lash Couture Super Strong Strip Lash Adhesive in clear. I keep getting these as well because I've been using fake eyelashes so much, and then at a certain point, your glue gets kind of clumpy, so you need to replace it. I just have a couple more things. We're almost done. So here's another foundation that I used up. Same thing, same color, same everything. Then we also have a product right here. This is the powder that I use to set my makeup. And this is just the CoverGirl Clean Invisible Powder, and it's a loose powder. So you just use it as a loose powder and you put it over your foundation and it like sets everything so you don't get all oily through the day. Your makeup pretty much stays where you want it to. So this is in the color 105 Translucent Fair. So that's what I use on top of my makeup. And that is it, guys. So that's it for my empties. Thank you so much for watching. I definitely appreciate it. Let me know if you have any comments about any of these products. I would definitely love to hear your thoughts on some of these products. Go ahead and drop your comments down below in the comment section. I would love to know what you think about these products as well. I hope you did enjoy this video. If you did, go ahead and give me a big thumbs up. And if you do like content like this, I would definitely love for you to take a moment and hit that subscribe button. I do new videos every single week, and I would love to have you as a subscriber. I love you guys so much. I hope you have a beautiful day, and I will see you in the next video.